students, myself, Sarita Nair from Gokule Education Society, HIL High School. I am going to teach you subject General Science of Standard 7th.
Students, in this lesson number 2, we shall learn about plants, structure and function. Students, which are the various parts of plants? The root, stem, leaves, flowers, fruits, etc. of different plants are different. We can identify plants with the help of these different characteristics. Let us now familiarize ourselves with these plant organs in greater detail. We shall learn about formation of root. Let's try this. Keep a moistened ball of crumpled paper in a conical flask. Place some soaked moth beans in the flask between the paper and the glass wall. Observe and note the changes in the seeds in 2 or 3 days. The part that grows from inside the seed toward the soil is called the radical, and the part that grows above the soil is called the plumule. The root that forms from the radical grows into the ground. The root is thick near the ground and gradually tapers to a pointed end. The part of the plant growing below the soil for support is called root. Now we will learn about root. Roots of some plants produce secondary roots that grow obliquely and spread far and wide in the soil. Roots support the plant. This type of root is called a taproot. Roots bear hair-like processes near the root tips. These are root hairs. The root tip is delicate. This is the region of the growth of the root. The tip is covered by cap-like structure called the root cap. The root cap protects the root tip from injuries. Let's see fibrous roots. Thread-like or fiber-like roots arising from the stem are called fibrous roots. Thus, there are two main types of roots, taproots and fibrous roots. Dicotyledonous plants have taproots, while monocotyledonous plants have fibrous roots. Plants like maize, sugarcane, sorghum have two types of roots. Some roots are underground, whereas some grow from the stem just above the soil. The latter are called adventitious roots. Besides the normal functions like absorption of water and minerals, anchoring and supporting the plant, roots perform some other functions too. Roots show some modifications to perform these additional functions. Some examples of such modified roots are aerial roots, slit roots, runners, breathing roots, etc. Let's learn about the stem. The stem grows above the soil from the plumule of the sprouting seed. As the sprout grows, the length of stem gradually increases too. There are nodes on the stem. Leaves come out at the nodes. The part of the stem between two nodes is called an internode. The tip or the apical end of the stem is called a bud. You can observe any branch of any plant and see all these different parts of the stem. Now, we shall learn about different parts of leaf. Leaves arise from the nodes on a stem. Generally, leaves are thin, flat and green in color. Leaf blade or lamina, the broad, spread out part of the leaf. Leaf margin, it is at the edge of the leaf. Types of leaf margins are the entire, dentate and lobed. Then the tip of the leaf is known as leaf apex. And there are also different types of leaves like tapering, pointed or rounded. The stalk of the leaf is known as the petiole. Some leaves have petioles, some do not have petiole. And the portion of the leaf attached to the stem is known as leaf base. Stipules, small leaf-like structures near the leaf base. Some leaves have stipules, some do not have stipules. Now there are also some types of many more types of leaves like simple leaves and compound leaves. These are the main types of leaf. Simple leaf are divided, they have divided leaf blade with single midrib. And compound leaf, they are divided into many small leaflets. In different plants, the arrangement of leaves on the stem is different. It may be alternate, opposite, whorled, spiral, etc. According to shape, leaves are rounded, palmate, lanceolate, linear, etc. Now let's learn about parts of a flower. The stalk of the flower is called pedicel. It may be long or short. One end is attached to stem. End of the pedicel which is attached to flower is enlarged and swollen. This is called a receptacle. Outermost oval of the flower green in color and protective in nature. The petals in bud condition are covered over by calyx. Petals make the corolla. Petals may be colored or white. Androecium, the male reproductive part of the flower, which is made up of stamens. Each stamen has an anther and a filament. Gynoecium, the female reproductive part of the flower, which is made up of carpels. Each carpel consists of stigma, style, and ovary. Now we shall learn about fruits. Students, we eat many different types of fruits. Each type of fruit has its own characteristics. There are variations in their shape, color, taste, etc. Mango contains only one seed, whereas jackfruit consists of many small fruitlets, each with its own seed. Now observe the fruits of bear, mango, chiku, apple, etc. Each fruit has a different skin or shell, fleshy part and seed. In case of fruits like cashew, its seed is outside the fruit. Students, you can also do an experiment that soak the seeds of pea, wheat, rice, jowar, groundnut in water for 3-4 hours. Press the seeds with your fingers and observe them. Which seeds get divided into two equal parts? Seeds which get divided into two equal parts are called dicotyledonous. Seeds which do not divide into two equal parts are called monocotyledonous seeds. I hope you all understood.
So students, in this way we have completed the lesson. Hope you all understood it. Now we will read the lesson carefully and try to solve the exercise given below it. In the next video, we shall learn a new lesson.